8 months after the Green Poison virus was unleashed in New York City, and 1 month after our deployment to Washington DC, a new threat appears. Heavily armed, highly trained enemies are occupying the city, jeopardizing everything the division and civilians have achieved. Upon completing the campaign, the Black Tusks invaded DC. Heavily armed and highly trained and being a tech-focused military, they challenge you for the control over control points, settlements, and campaign missions. Using advanced tactics as well as technology based on Shade Tech, they are foes unseen before, almost being similar to the hunters we've seen in Manhattan. The PvE endgame is the constant battle on their invaded missions and taking back control of the capital. To do this, you're going to need all the information we have. Luckily, this intro brief goes in depth on the Black Tusks and their archetypes. The Black Tusk assaults are ex-special forces, marines, rangers, SEALs, you name it. Coming from every hellhole on the planet. The most basic of the Black Tusk forces, these infantrymen prefer fighting from behind cover and move cover to avoid enemy fire and push up on you. The Black Tusk Thrower is that guy who is obsessed with explosives. I used to think these airburst grenade launchers were cool, but these guys make me regret ever thinking that. Besides being equipped with an assault rifle, they use an airburst grenade launcher to hit targets behind cover. These can be destroyed mid-air, although this is hard. Flank them to destroy the grenade pouch on the side, killing them in the explosion. The Black Tusk Rusher is a mean little guy. Using his submachine gun, he will try to push on you, but before he does, he deploys 2 suicide drones and uses a targeting laser to pick his target. Imagine the cost of these drones. Simply keeping him deploying his drones is a significant capital outlay, showing that your death is worth a lot. The drones are easily destroyed, but destroying his drone pouch causes an explosion, permanently erasing the rusher. His equipment is also vulnerable to an EMP effect if you can get your hands on the jammer pulse. The Black Tusk Medic revolutionizes battlefield triage, making it possible to get to downed soldiers in remote or exposed locations. He throws EMP jammers to disrupt Shade Tech skills and attempts to revive downed allies via a medical drone. The drone is destructible, however, it's smarter to shoot it on the medic's backpack as it prevents range revival and forces the medic to run down to allies to revive them. To prevent him from jamming your Shade Tech, shooting the EMP jammer pouch sets off an EMP that disrupts him, being unable to use his skills. The Black Tusk Sniper is the best of the best. They use every dirty trick in the book, and on top of that, their target acquisition is top notch. Using the MK20 SSR marksman rifle, the sniper takes cover at long range, attempting to eliminate targets from afar. To distract the target, he sets up a decoy lens that can be confused for the real position. On top of that, the sniper can deploy a taser drone that seeks out hostiles and stuns them, granting the sniper a clear headshot. Although you will be able to destroy the decoy lenses and drones, it's smarter to destroy the lens and drone pouches the sniper carries to prevent them from deploying their equipment. That leaves them vulnerable to your flanks and shots. The Black Tusk controller is one that uses technological advancements on a whole new level. While staying in cover with only his pistol in the meantime, he controls what one might describe as a cute little bomb disposal robot turned murder tank. This mini tank has a machine gun mounted on one side and a grenade launcher on the other. Besides, it has a very large health pool. Shooting the wheels drains its health faster, making the controller attempt to repair it. The smarter move is to distract or eliminate the controller. This temporarily or completely disables the mini tank. The Black Tusk Warhound is a product of American government invests in the future of warfare, that being robotics and artificial intelligence. This heavily armored quadruped attempts to position itself with a clear line of sight to its target and uses a powerful deployed charged rifle. Once locked on, the laser turns red, but before this happens, its cannon can be temporarily disabled by interrupting its charge. Upon its destruction, it triggers a self-destruct sequence, which sets off an EMP. This disables any equipment in its direct radius, no matter if it's friend or foe. The Black Tusk tank archetype is the worst. Literally, if you see him coming, I'm like, nope, 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 and head the other way. He's dressed in heavy armor, carries a belt-fed minigun, meaning he never has to reload, and is supplied by a health recovering support station on his back. The minigun is used to suppress enemies, he stays at range to prevent heavy damage and is being fed health constantly. Three strategies making it an incredibly hard target to eliminate. Shooting his armor can destroy it, but it isn't the best option. Aim for the minigun ammo belt to force him to reload, and if the opportunity presents itself, destroying the support station on his back stops his health regeneration. The Black Tusk Lieutenant, in the case of the Jefferson Trade Center, he's called Luka Horn Milic, is equipped with an RPG. Other than that, there is no tactical information available on the lieutenants. The Black Tusks are the most lethal faction encountered in Washington DC. So far, they are more than a match for the Division agents. You're now prepared to counter their movement in taking back DC. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the faction briefing, I would like to ask you to like or dislike, share, subscribe, and click the notification bell to become part of the Masterminds HD community and notification squad. On top of that, you can follow me on Twitter for daily updates and join my Discord if you're looking for an engaged community that revolves around Tom Clancy's Division 1 and 2. Both links are in the description. Visit my Patreon page through the link in the description if you're interested in the intel briefing on the Black Tusk or other intel briefings in general. Each faction will have one with the summarized information from their videos. To end this particular video, I have a question for you. What is in your opinion the most interesting archetype that is part of the Black Tusk's lineup? Leave your answer in the comment section down below and I'll make sure to get back to you. I'll talk to you in the next video on Discord or on Twitter. Peace out.